Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Praise the living Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Let's have our seat for 1 minute. I want to thank Daddy and Mommy for this privilege. I'm not taking it for granted. And all the anointed people up there, thank you so much. And I just want to believe that this is the day that the Lord has made. Because I was here in the morning instead of afternoon. We were about to go, and the car behind us, we had about 3 cars. So there was no way we could go. By the time they could move it, it was already 4 o'clock. So we just thought, what's the point? So definitely, there is a reason. Tell somebody there is a reason. And I will not miss my home blessing today. You see, when the message was going on in the morning, when our daddy in the Lord was preaching, because every time I go out to minister, anytime I enter that church, I always ask God, Lord, what do you want me to do? That's why you will never see me preparing a list to say this is the song I want to sing. And as the ministration was going on, there was a song that was really pressing in my heart. And I said, maybe there is a reason. Maybe there's someone here that God just wants to tell you that even though it's so dark out there, there is a light at the end of the tunnel. And he says, his thought for us is of good and not of evil. We might be, I've been asking and praying for so long, and you think God has forgotten you. I just want to use this testimony of mine, you know, to tell you that God cares. Tell somebody God cares.
God cares.
You only need to change some little things. Eh? You just need to change some little things. And let us make our way right with the Lord. God help us in Jesus' name. The title of the song says, He will never let you down. You know, we all go through situations and phases of life. And this very song has taken me from one phase to the other. And I bless the name of the Lord because everywhere this song is ministered, there is always a testimony. And I say this afternoon, your own will not be exemption. In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
It's a reggae song. The choirs, don't worry, you'll be fine. Yeah, you will cope with me. I'll go first.
He will never let you down. Christ will never let you down. If you call unto the Lord, He will never let you down. Oh, never let you down. Never let you down.
Choir.
He will never let you down. Christ will never let you down. If you call unto the Lord, He will never let you down. Oh, never let you down. Never let you down. I have tasted of His love.
Brethren,
I have tasted of His goodness. Christ has never let me down.
Believe me,
He has never failed me. When sorrow fills your heart and it seems your way is wrong, Christ would never let you down.
Do you believe?
He would never let you down. Oh, He would never let you down.
I know.
Christ would never let you down. He would go. Jesus Christ is alive, and He has found to change situation. Christ will never let you down. He will never let you down. When you think all hope is lost, if you can hold on to the Lord, Christ will never fail you. Trust me, He will never let you down. He will never let. Maybe you will understand it better. I remember 2007, I had an immigration issue. Immigration asked me to pack my load and go.
I'm among people with British passports. I thought you would clap and praise the Lord. And praise the Lord on my behalf. Do you know how many people have been deported? For the fact that I'm here today. You can sit down for now, let me finish my story. And then we know where we are going. I remember sometimes this year, they said they want to deport several thousands Nigerians. And not today. They are still deporting so many people. And here we are today. Tell somebody, it's by the grace of the Lord. I don't know what you are going through. I'm not going through my immigration or British passport. I'm just giving you a testimony. And I want you to cling to that testimony. If the Lord can do my whole, come on, your problem is so simple. I don't know what you're going through. Maybe you're looking for the fruit of the womb. Or you've applied for jobs several times. And all they could tell you is no, no, no. Maybe your family has written you off. And they say you cannot amount to anybody. Because you are the Lord Jesus, your tomorrow will be okay. Because you believe in the Lord, hey, your tomorrow will be alright. Hey, if only you can hold on to your faith. If only you can pray. If only you can humble yourself and cry to God of heaven. My Jesus will never let you down. My daddy will never fail you. Okay, look to somebody beside you. Tell them my sister said, yes, he go better, oh, he go better, he go better, oh, I know, he go better, oh, he go better, oh, I'm sure, hey, he go better, oh, he go better, he go better, oh, I say I know, he go better, oh, he go better, he go better, oh. You know why? Because Jesus Christ in me, he's the hope of my glory. Hey! Jesus Christ in me, he's the hope of my glory. I said with Jesus in my life, I know my tomorrow will be okay. With Jesus in my life, my tomorrow will be alright. We are now at that junction. Just close your eyes wherever you are. The hour has come. The maker of heaven and the earth. The covenant keeping God. Hey! Do me a favor. I don't know what you're going through. If you have been touched by this song, just do me a favor. Lay your hands upon your chest. To be obedient is better than sacrifice. Just lay your hands upon your chest. I want you to make a covenant with the Lord. David said, I will not do anything that will not cost me unto the Lord. I'm not asking you to come and drop 1,000, 2,000. No. Make a covenant. Maybe you are the type that you've been serving God before due to one discouragement on the other. You have looked at it and said, anyway, let's just do it for religious purpose. This is the time to make that covenant and say, Father, I'm ready to come back. I'm ready to do your will. And if you are the type that you are so stingy with your tithe, this is the hour to make a U-turn. And you will see your finances being changed around for good. You know it. Even if you are here and you are still looking for a job, you are the best person at this position. Even if it's one penny in your hand, God is not looking at the value. He looks just right at your heart, the mind behind it, and drop it at the altar and say, Father, I'm clinging to this. You don't have to do it now. You can do it later. But I want you to make a covenant, something that will cost you. Not something you have in excess, but something that will cost you. It will cost you your time. Make a covenant with the Lord. And as I will be singing this song, I want you to come forward and let the man of God pray for you. And do me a favor. By the time we count to 10, I beg you in the name of the Lord, don't join them. After 10, don't join. Covenant keeping God. Hey. There is no one like you. If you are laying your hands on your chest, come to the front. Alpha and Omega. Hey. There is no one like you. The New Life Church, you answer by fire. Oh, hey. Hear the cry of your people, Lord. Open the floodgates in abundance. Coming, you can keep coming. One, if you are coming, please come. Two, oh, praise ye the Lord. If you are rededicating your life, God needs you more. You are there, you don't know Christ. Forget about this testimony. If you don't know Christ, you cannot be partaker of it. If you are giving your life to Christ, heaven rejoice upon you. Come straight to the front. Don't just stay among the people. Come straight to the front. Or you are the one that has been serving God and you have been discouraged. You need proper follow-up. Come to the front. The Lord help you. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You, that particular person, you are there. You need to give your life to Christ. Doing it in secret will not help you. Glory to you, Jesus. Just begins to speak to God. Don't just stand there. Speak to the Lord. The Lord is here in the midst of his people. Daddy.
When the sister is minister, where you saw, where you see what I saw, you will key with it. For me to come out to key with it, you are still sitting down. Please come and key with it. You drop it now, not tomorrow. The hand of God is upon this house. Thank you, Jesus. See, the man of God, he to eat. Prophetic ministry is different to ordinary ministry. God, open your eyes. It's not her speaking. It's not her. There is dew coming down from heaven. When in ministry, praise the Lord. You bring your own, just drop it and let's pray. Drop it and let's pray. It's a covenant between you and God. And see what is, either you believe this or not, it is happening already. Either you believe it or not, it is happening already. This is a prophetic ministry. It will change your life. It will change your attention. If not because of the protocol of today, I will tell that sister to repeat that song. But because of the protocol, you are coming back, man. You are coming back. He picked that song from Exodus 9:4, and he picked it from the book of Psalm 34, 8 and 9. Taste and see will never disappoint you. Just keep with the covenant. Keep with the covenant. Keep with the covenant. Here with the covenant. They are not going to pack it until we finish. The angel that is in this house, they are more than 21. They are more than 21. They are more than 21. Either you believe it or not, it will happen in your life. The lies will turn to truth in your life. You have been going to conference. You have been going to convention. You have been attending revival. This year own is totally different. It's totally different. It's totally different. It's totally different. As you make covenant with the Jehovah Almighty, the Lord of hosts, before the end of this week, if you can, your amen should roar like a thunder, your situation will change. Amen. That challenges that stand against you as a river, I decree and I declare, as we make covenants right now, the river will dry up. Amen. In the book of Genesis 35, God himself visited Jacob. He said, I am the God of Bethel. He introduced himself to Jacob. Jacob had forgotten the covenant. He had forgotten what he had done to God. He said, where you anointed the pillar. And God said, I come now. I remember your offering. I remember your sacrifice. I remember year 2016 and I visited you. And he said, now you are returning to your father's house. Everyone key to this covenant today, as failure of this sister have turned to success, whatever thing failure in your life, they will turn to success. Amen. Your shame will turn to grace. Amen. The Lord will cover every nakedness. Amen. So shall it be. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen.